Hey, it's SGU, and welcome back to more MLB The Show 17 coverage. This is one of our characters that's been around a couple of years now, ported into the game from MLB The Show 16. This is the series that is modeled after myself, Matt Meyer, my namesake, catcher for the Toronto Blue Jays. He's been with a few organizations now, but this is his most recent stop in Toronto. We've ported him in to the brand new Road to the Show in MLB The Show 17. We've got the new hub here to look at in the clubhouse. The Blue Jays will be taking on the Boston Red Sox here to start off our very first MLB The Show 17 episode of the Matt Meyer series. And, well, there you go. Wanted to take advantage of one of the things that was brand new for the Blue Jays this year, their red home alternate jerseys and caps. So we get to wear these for the first time. Why not do it the first game right out the bat? So here we are at Rogers Center, down 1-0 to the Red Sox. This is a solid rip to center field and get down for a hit. It'll do just that. Single for Meyer. And he is dialed in here. Side note here, you can get some two-time multipliers for big events in Road to the Show this year when the manager presents you with something going on. But I've actually got a lengthy two-time multiplier going because with the pre-order of 17, a lot of stubs were awarded for 16 to finish off the year. And I really wasn't going to do anything in there Diamond Dynasty-wise. So I went through basically all my major Road to the Show players and gave them 120 game two-time multiplier streaks. So a lot of our guys are going to have those streaks, as that does carry over from one game to the next when you port it. Didn't know that, but I found that out. So I took advantage of that. That ball is not out of the yard, but it is down for a hit, and he could have three. Head first slide, it's a triple for Meyer. Now that's something more accustomed to Skeeter Rabbit with his speed, but this one kind of gets away from the outfielders a little bit. Didn't know if it was going to be gone, and yeah, kind of gets over the center fielder's head. He runs into the wall. Ball kind of caroms back towards center field there, and he's able to get to third. So it's 4-2 right now. This ball, is it deep enough for him to tag up on? Again, he's no Skeeter Rabbit, but he should be able to score easily on that play. Ball comes in, and they have no chance to get him at the plate. So he gets the triple, and then the sacrifice fly by Stanton brings him home. And you see right now, to this point, Meyer 2-for-3 with a triple, a single, and a run scored. Let's see what he does in this at-bat. Toronto up 5-2, and it's just a little number down the line. Pitcher's going to get it. He holds on to that throw. It's an infield single, his third hit of the game. And the Toronto faithful are loving what they're seeing from their newly acquired free agent slugger. Okay, Toronto might be good luck wearing the alternate reds as we get a win here tonight. Let's remember that. I'm sure I'll have a steady diet of those uniforms since they are brand new in the game, and it's always fun to have new threads to show off. 6-2 is the final. I kind of like that they show the game wrap-up now, even if it doesn't end on one of your plays. Instead of just seeing like the dugout scene, you get to see the celebration scene. And, you know, it's not really that different either way. It's just kind of a nice, fresh approach to the Road to the Show presentation. So we've won the first two games in this Red Sox series. We are two games above 500 now. Meyer comes into this game hitting just over 400. Blazing hot start he's had, and this is going to be a grounder up the middle. Shortstop sets and throws, and he's going to have time to throw him out. So nothing doing in his first at bat. Boston up 1-0, but he got two runners on in the third inning. This pitch is high, and he likes to swing at these. All my sluggers do when I can find that pitch, and it's not coming back. It's a Meyer moonshot, the first in MLB The Show 17 for Matt Meyer, and this one, holy smokes, it got into that upper deck, restaurant area, whatever that is back there. VIP seating is delivered. A home run ball via the bat of Matt Meyer. A Meyer moonshot. That one was really propelled out of here, and he is going to hear it from the dugout here. Lots of congratulations, as I believe that it's his 25th of the season. Let's watch it again. A towering fly ball. And when this thing finally comes down, we get a good look at the banners out there. And where does it land? Holy cow, that was hit deep. Okay, so it's 5-2 Toronto. He gets another at bat, and this one, he's going to get through the left side of the infield for a hit. So he's on again with a single this time. Boston probably feels lucky that it is just a single and not a home run this time around. But still, getting on base and producing. And that's exactly what they're going to want to see out of his bat. The Blue Jays win the game, and not only that, they sweep the series. And they are on the right track here now. Still a good 5-6 games out of first place in the Yankees, but gaining some momentum here and sweeping a division rival. So that's going to feel good as they pack up and head to Baltimore for a series. You see the social media on the right-hand side. We'll kind of keep tracking that, too. There's some kind of funny stuff going on there once in a while in some of the comments. But the Orioles ready to hit the field at Oriole Park at Camden Yards. Blue Jays ready to go as well. And here you go. Meyer stepping into the box. Now 25 round trippers on the season. First inning and a 2-0 count. And that one just gets in on the hands. Didn't really care to swing at that, but it did, and it's too late. It's an easy, shallow fly ball to left field. Not the at-bat we were looking for, especially up 2-0 in the count. Well, this one, he gets to atone for it. He hits this a long way to right center field. See you later. It's another Meyer moonshot. He knew it right off the bat as he went into his home run trot immediately. And with that two-time boost, we're getting some nice XP for that, as that is number 26 on the season. Manager approves. Looks like kind of improved detailing on player and manager faces this year. So that solo homer went 434 feet. Let's take another look at it. Cue that replay. I like the replay wipes and overlays a lot better this year. I think they run a lot smoother. They look really sharp. This ball, see you later, 434 feet. And nice catch out there, it looks like, by an Orioles fan. 3-2, Toronto in the lead in the third. We're catching behind the plate here. Got to show a little bit of our defensive efforts. Framing a pitch for strike three. Think he went around with the bat anyway. Hey, good chance to see what we got going on with check swings this year. Do we still have a glitch? Yeah, it glitched a little bit. Doesn't quite look as ridiculous as it did in some of the at-bats last year, and I haven't really had one with me batting yet, so jury's still out on the check swing glitch. That one looked like a proper check swing. I'm not able to throw the runner out at second base, and the Orioles quite good at stealing bases this year. As you see right there, they're up among the American League leaders. It's 10-3 Orioles right now. This one is tomahawk to center field, but that is going to be caught. So it's an out. It's 13-7. Man, it's like a couple touchdowns and a missed extra point right now. But we're going to get on the board again with another line shot to center. This time, that gets out in a hurry. A frozen rope line drive to center field. And he's done it for the second time today. That's number 27 on the season. 433 feet. Consistent there. Long bombs, Meyer moonshots. Let's watch this replay. Cue it up for me, please. Here we go, Blue Jays logo. And now our replay. And like I said, hit on a line. This thing might have still been rising when it hit the back wall there. That was an impressive line drive shot. So he's 2-for-4, 2 homers, 2 RBI, 2 runs scored. And he's up again. And could he make it a 3-home-run day? Well, they could certainly use it. They're down 14-8. This pitch, another line drive, and it couldn't be. It is another Meyer moonshot, another line drive variety. He's been absolutely dialed in on those last two swings as far as hitting that about as hard as you could hit a baseball. And that one once again finds the seats. 3 home runs on the game, 28 on the season. We haven't had a chance to see the MLB Network exit velocity stats and all that stuff. I'm sure we'll get one where we get a home run and we'll get that graphic, but haven't seen it yet. It'll be kind of cool when we do get to see that, the trajectory and exit velocity and all that stuff. Right now, the Orioles looking to pad their lead. That one's in the gap. Could I finally have a play at the plate? Come on. All last year, I was hoping for one. Oh, not quite. He's in ahead of the throw. I was hoping just maybe once I'd have a legit play at the plate. Still waiting for that. The Orioles win, and they win it big. They win something by like 10 runs here. We'll have to check the final score. I don't even know if we're going to see the final score. Anyway, 3 home runs and a loss for Matt Meyer.
This player's multiple home run performance has his batting coach fired up.
Ah, nice. So the interactions in the clubhouse aren't just reserved for your brand new players coming through on road to the show. We're talking with our hitting coach here. You see the options. I can be kind of cocky about it. I can just kind of brush it off. You know what? 3 home runs is a pretty big deal. We either go boom goes the dynamite or, yeah, we're going to go big dog, got to eat. So he says if we keep doing that, he's going to get paid big time. Well, we'll try to keep making hitting coach look good and have those multiple home run games. So we're just kind of checking our social media feed over here. Got people wanting autographs. Meet me outside. How about that? Some kind of funny stuff in there if you check it out once in a while. That social media feed, a nice addition. So we went from sweeping the Red Sox to being in a position where we could be swept by the Orioles. A kind of reversal of fortune here, hoping that's not the case. So Meyer, after hitting 3 home runs in that first game we featured, now at 28 on the young season. Oh, man. Can somebody say 29? Now he knows that thing is gone. Again, a bomb to right center field. That is a Meyer moonshot, and I can't wait to see the tape on this one. As, wow, that was a 3-run shot and puts the Blue Jays ahead in the early going. All right, let's see what this one, 462 feet for his 29th of the season. Not going to hit too many longer than that right there. Oh, we're going to see it here. Show track, exit velocity, launch angle. Nice. I love it. I love the new MLB Network overlays, statistics. We got hang time, projected distance. That's sweet. It's a very nice addition to the game and used sporadically there as we haven't seen that one up until now. So he steps in, already a 3-run homer under his belt. Toronto up 4-0. 2 on again, and oh my goodness, is this fair? If it is, it's absolutely gone. He crushed it again. Another 3-run shot. He has 6 RBIs with 2 swings of the bat. So it's quite interesting here. All the past several years I've played on veteran with sliders kind of bumped up for contact and power and that kind of stuff. I found a good blend I like. Well, since I got the game here, MLB The Show 17, I've been going dynamic difficulty because I kind of wanted to do an experiment and see where I would end up if I let the dynamic difficulty take over. Well, you're going to see after these 2 bombs here to start this game off, I come up for my next at bat, and I believe you're going to see it up in the top corner here. It's going to bump me. Yep, difficulty increased, and it's really quick there, but it's from veteran to all-star. I guess it was veteran plus to all-star, so that's interesting. It could always slide back if I kind of meet the high end of my skills, but that is quite interesting. So still, sliders in my favor a little bit, but we've bumped up from veteran to all-star now. So I just thought I'd point that out because it was up on the screen there. Now that we get feedback about that and my dynamic difficulty experiment is underway, well, maybe our pitchers need a little decrease in dynamic difficulty because that ball is gone. And all of a sudden, all those runs we put up on the board via Matt Meyer's bat have evaporated. The Orioles take the lead with Taylor Slade's home run. Holy smokes. Lots of runs in this series and in this game in particular once again. And, well, they're going to need Meyer's bat again. 3-for-4 with the 6 RBI, but they trail 11-9. That's a single to center field, and that's going to be his 7th RBI of the game. He's producing so many runs, and yet it looks like it's going to be in a losing effort again. Well, I don't know. Maybe they can complete the comeback here. But he now has 4 hits and 7 RBI on the game. Career day for him right here in Baltimore. But again, it's going to take a little more for this team to fully come back and win a crazy one. Well, it's 11-10 now. Baltimore in the lead. And it's going to continue there in the 8th inning as that ball drops for a hit. Now you got runners at 1st and 2nd. They need a timely 2-out hit. Can they get it? The pitch. Strike 3. Huge emotion on the mound right there as the inning is over. Wow, a huge strikeout by Martinez. Let's watch it again and watch as he delivers this and his reaction. I've always seen the pump fist before. I don't know if I've seen the sit down and squat and double fist pump, but that's a pretty good looking animation. And that's a good looking series for Baltimore as they sweep us. A lot of runs scored here, a lot of home runs hit. You see the line for Matt Meyer, but once again, in a loss.
This young team is introduced to one of baseball's lowest feelings, ending a series with nothing to show in the win column.
All right, so they point out the fact that we got swept. Manager is basically going to challenge us to not have this happen to us very often, and it's going to offer us a 2-time multiplier event, which actually means for me it should be a 4-time multiplier since I already have the 2-time multiplier streak going for quite some time. So that'll rack up some points for sure for us, especially if we're continuing to hit the ball in the seats. So there you go. Matt Meyer has been ported over to MLB The Show 17. It'll be his new home from here on out. And I'm liking what I see so far. I've rode to the show, having a lot of fun. Leave a like, subscribe. We'll see you next time for more Meyer Moonshots and Toronto baseball. We'll see you then.